Assalamu alaikum dear students, your biology teacher Madam Farzana Suhail here with the first lecture of unit number 11, gaseous exchange. This unit is from your metric book, which is the first unit of your class 10th. First of all, we are going to study the definitions of respiration, gaseous exchange and breathing. Respiration, it is an energy releasing process at cellular level. In this process, food molecules are broken down into simpler compounds like carbon dioxide and water with the release of energy. Second definition is of gaseous exchange. It means the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide between an organism and its environment. Gaseous exchange is mostly used for the plant's bodies because they are not having a proper system of gaseous exchange. Breathing, it is a physical process in which animals move air into and out of their body. It is done to get oxygen and release carbon dioxide gas. Usually the student confuse the definition of respiration and breathing. Here, by studying these two definitions, it will be clear to you that breathing is only a step of respiration, whereas respiration takes place at cellular level. The oxygen gas which is required for the process of respiration is going to be provided to the body by the process of breathing, and this breathing is done with the help of breathing system in the body of the animals. We cannot use the term breathing for the plants because this breathing needs a proper system, which is called breathing system. The next topic is gaseous exchange in plants. In plants, gaseous exchange takes place differently during day and night time. First, we are going to study about gaseous exchange during daytime. During daytime, all the living cells are carrying out respiration. The green parts of the plants are also carrying out photosynthesis. These two processes are taking place side by side during daytime. For photosynthesis, the leaves use carbon dioxide, which is produced during respiration. Some of the carbon dioxide is produced in the plant's body as a result of respiration. They also take carbon dioxide from the environment, but the carbon dioxide which is produced as a result of respiration is insufficient for the plants, so they take in carbon dioxide from the external environment too. During respiration, they release carbon dioxide which is used in photosynthesis. So during daytime, leaves are taking carbon dioxide and releasing oxygen to the environment. Now we are having gaseous exchange during nighttime. During nighttime, all cells are carrying out respiration while there is no photosynthesis. As at nighttime, no sunlight is there, so the process of photosynthesis stops at nighttime, and the only process which takes place that is respiration. So the cells get oxygen from the environment and release carbon dioxide. So that's why it is advised not to sleep beneath the trees at night time, because the plant are going to take out a large amount of carbon dioxide, which can cause suffocation for the individuals who are sleeping beneath the trees or plants. Dear friends, here we are having the diagrams of three parts of the plants. First of all, in the first diagram, we can see the plant which is taking in sunlight, carbon dioxide and water from the external environment. During daytime, you can see that the plants are taking out oxygen gas because the process of photosynthesis produces oxygen gas as a byproduct. In the middle diagram, we are having the internal structure of leaf. The upper part of the leaf is called upper epidermis. The lower part of the leaf is called lower epidermis. In the lower epidermis, you can see there are openings which are called stomata. These stomata help in the exchange of gases during daytime and during nighttime too. The other diagram is of a mature stem. The mature stem is going to take carbon dioxide gas or oxygen gas with the help of openings which are called lenticels. The next topic in our metric book is tilling. You can see a tractor which is here in front of you. Tilling helps soil drainage and aeration. It creates air spaces between soil particles. These spaces in turn helps in better exchange of gases between roots and the air. Usually farmers and gardeners do tilling before any crop. It makes the soil soft and it makes easy for the seeds to exchange air with the environment. Now, dear students, we are moving towards gaseous exchange in humans. Humans have an efficient respiratory system adapted for the terrestrial mode of life. This system ensures a smooth exchange of gases between the environment and the human body. This system can be divided into two main components, which are air passageway and lungs. Let's study them in detail. First, we are having air passageway. When air enters the body, it passes through connected tubes to reach the lungs. These connected tubes are called the air passageway. It consists of external nostrils, nasal cavities, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, and finally alveoli. In these two diagrams, you can see it easily that these different parts of the air passageway are mentioned. Now, the second part of the human breathing system is lungs. Lungs are placed in chest cavity. From above side, lungs are enclosed by chest wall, while from the lower side, thick muscular structure called diaphragm is present. Each lung is enclosed in a double membrane called pleura. It consists pleural fluid. This fluid makes the movement of the lungs easy. Chest cavity is bounded by the ribs and muscles at the side called intercostal muscles. On the ventral side of chest cavity, backbone is present. Lungs are protected by all these components because the lungs are going to protect the heart too, and they are going to provide oxygenated blood to the heart too. That is the most sensitive part of the human body. Now, here we are having the topic of gaseous exchange in lungs. The alveoli are very thin walled and have network of blood capillaries. So they are excellent site of gaseous exchange. The blood which enters these capillaries has a low oxygen concentration. Therefore, oxygen from the alveoli diffuses into the capillaries. Similarly, carbon dioxide from the capillaries diffuses into the alveoli. With the help of this diagram, you can see the blood which is coming towards the alveoli and the blood which is going away from the alveoli. The blood which is coming towards the alveoli is called deoxygenated blood because of the presence of carbon dioxide. When it is going to leave the alveoli, the blood has been turned into oxygenated blood because it has absorbed oxygen from the alveoli. Now, dear students, this is question answer session, which is called critical thinking. Question number one is, what is the structure of chest cavity? You are going to describe the structure of the chest cavity. Question number two is, why gaseous exchange is different in plants during daytime and night time? You are going to give the basic reason that what is the reason due to which gaseous exchange in plants is different during daytime than at night time. Thank you, dear students, for being here with me. Stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz.